This is my Royal live center, Versa center, part number 10833. I'm looking at the thing and I'm going, oh boy, how's that come apart? There's no screws, there's no set screws, there's nothing, you know. And looking at their drawing, so I go, well, I'm just gonna hold it and see if I can tap this part off, right? This part here. And you know, I just started tapping on it with a dead blow hammer, you know, soft hammer, and it came apart. I mean, it took a little bit, but it wasn't too bad. It came right apart. So anyway. This is kind of what it looks like. I'm not going to take this part insides out. This is the one half of the race for the thrust bearing. And then actually that turns in there, but I can't pull it out. It probably come out pretty easy, but there's no need to. Then there's the other, that little small bearing. You know, as you refer to the drawing, you'll see the small bearing down in there. Now, I don't know what the OD of that bearing is. The large bearing sits here. So here's the thrust bearing. Just one of these open cage ones with two hard faces. And these are, you know, these faces, these aren't, you know, real thin. They're, oh, they're about, you know, they're about 140,000, 150,000 thick, these faces for the thrust bearing. So there's two of those, and the balls, the, you know, this sits in here. And the balls are 0.281 in diameter. So, you know, that thrust bearing is, you know, a little bit thick. So this big bearing's a NSK 6204 bearing. I don't know what the thrust bearing is, and I don't know what the small one is down inside. So the shaft is obviously pressed on to the big bearing. This shaft is all one piece. This flange here, and this flange has a slope to it, and everything's got a radius, you know, down in here, right down in here, there's a, you know, this has a small radius, you know, to give it some strength, I mean, you know, so anti-fracture, and I'm sure it's all hardened, but this bearing's pressed on there, this is pressed on too, so, you know, lightweight grease, and that just goes right in there, and the press fit for that on here is not that much. I mean, it's a little bit, but I just knocked this part off with a dead blow hammer, small one, so it wasn't too bad. Anyway, so that's about it. It's not a lot to it there. Pretty simple. Yeah, this one's a Morris taper number 3. This is their Morris taper number 3 heavy duty. Now, I found mine on eBay. This thing is in great shape. It's like perfect condition, right? Except for there's a little ding here and there's some marks, you know, somebody, you know, made some cuts or something into the tip of this. And I hope to regrind that one of these days. I'll make sure everything's clean here. I think I might, I'll put some new grease on that a little bit, just a dab before I put it back together.